Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is George Andes. I'm a location coordinator here in Somerset for Reach Across America. I'm here to talk to you a little bit about Veterans Day. Veterans Day is a day set aside to honor men and women who have served in our armed forces, from World War I through Vietnam and the Persian Gulf to the current conflicts in Afghanistan and the War on Terror. On the 11th hour of the 11th day of the 11th month was the ending of World War I. 1 year later, President Woodrow Wilson proclaimed November 11th as Armistice Day. The day was originally set to honor World War I veterans, but in 1954, the Veterans Service Organization asked Congress to change Armistice to Veteran. So on June 1st, 1954, it was officially changed to Veterans Day to honor all who have served in our armed forces. This year, we commemorate the 75th anniversary of the ending of World War II. Today, the U.S. Department of Veterans Affairs estimates that 300,000 World War II veterans are still alive. We are honored to have 10 of those here in Somerset. So today especially, but every day, when you're out and about and you see a veteran wearing a hat, a pin, or any indication, proudly stop and say thank you and welcome home. Thank you.
Veterans Day is a day of recognition. Unlike Memorial Day, which honors the over 1 million military members who sacrificed their lives for our country, Veterans Day recognizes all veterans, all those who have served this country in time of war and in time of peacetime. To the 22 million living veterans who've served this country, we owe you a debt of gratitude that can never be repaid. On behalf of the members of VFW Post 8500, I'd like to say thank you and God bless our great nation.
Hello. This is State Senator Michael Rodericks. I am honored to have the privilege to be speaking to you on this Veterans Day. While we would normally be spending the week with parades, breakfasts, and dinners throughout the district to celebrate our veterans, this year we will have to make do with only our words. Unfortunately, words alone cannot express the gratitude that we all feel for those who have fought for our freedom. While we make sure to thank them today, the men and women who have served this great nation deserve our recognition and support every day throughout the year. To all of our veterans, I hope you enjoy this day and for all you have done to help keep us safe and to protect our liberty, I say thank you.
My name is Steve Souza and I'm the commander of Post 228 here in Somerset, Massachusetts. And I'm proud to say that we are a very, very active post. We're hovering around 300 members. And the good thing about us, I think, is that we have a very strong diversity of members. We have a number of females, a number of Korean War veterans, Vietnam veterans, Gulf War veterans, from all eras, have served to protect and serve. It's kind of like the police department protect and serve on their cars. Well, we did the same thing. And many of us spent many months and years away from our families to ensure that we have the safety and honor that we have today in our country. And I'd like to thank you all for supporting the veterans and the American Legion. And I just put a request out to all those elected officials, keep us veterans in mind, the people that fought for your freedom, the freedom for democracy, the freedom for free elections. And thank you very much.
This is our appreciation of you being a veteran and putting your life on the line for this country. Our freedoms are made and delivered to us on the backs of our veterans. And it's time for people to understand that we're just regular people from the community that wanna be able to stand out but still be on the background. We don't want any special light shined on us because we've already done our part. We're not heroes. The heroes are all in Arlington and other cemeteries across the country.
My name is George Amaral. I'm a World War II veteran from the Army Engineers.
That's in Somerset.
I served a lot of time in France, Germany, Philippines, Japan. Veterans Day means more to me than I guess a lot of people, because when I joined the service, I was gung ho, and I believed in America, and I still do today. I'm very proud. That's the reason why I feel so strongly about being an American and also a veteran. I'm very proud of what I've done. Maybe with the American Legion, I can do just a little bit more.